Hi, in this session, I'm going to show you how to create an XY scatter chart with labels. So these are the labels that will show up for our scatter chart. Basically, we have our XY, our x-axis and our y-axis, and the intersection of that gives us our data point here. And this is the table that this chart is getting its data off of. So let's go ahead and build something like this, and I'll show you some caveats and some things you might run into in building this and what you can do to fix it. So let me go into sheet 3 here. Let's go ahead and create our table. Let's say we have a table and we have items, and this is our x values and these are our y values. And we're just going to give these items generic names. I'm just going to type item 1, press Control Enter to stay within that cell, and I'm going to right mouse click and kind of drag this down, and what's going to do is it's going to increment those numbers. Let's say I just want 20 items. So I'll go ahead and select fill series, and it's going to select one. It's going to add item 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. down to 20. Now let's just put in some dummy values for our x and y values. I'll go ahead and select this range here, and I'm going to just use a random formula, a random function, and it's going to be called rand between. And I'm going to go ahead and tab to fill that out. And the bottom number, I'm just going to choose 10, and the top number 99. And then close parentheses. And since I selected this whole range from B2 to C21, when I press Control Enter, it will execute that function for everything within that range. Control Enter, and you can see that it's filled out that value. And this value will change if I go into formulas and click Calculate Now. You'll see that it changes here. Or if you can just press the F9 key. If I hover over this, it'll tell you. The keyboard shortcut is press F9 to do that. But I want these values to stay the same, so I'm going to just go ahead and select this, Control C to copy, and then just go ahead and Alt ESV. I'm going to go ahead and just paste the values. I just want the values to be pasted. So instead of that formula, that rand between formula, once I click OK, you'll notice when I click in any of the cells now, that formula is gone. So the usual way that you might think about how creating the XY scatter diagram is maybe you're in the cell and you click insert and you click scatter and you select that. And what it's really done is it selected the values incorrectly. And that's one of the things that you'll come across. What I like to do is I like to kind of just start from scratch. I like to go ahead and select a cell that's outside of the table. Therefore, when you go ahead and click insert the scatter chart, Excel won't try to guess and pick from that table. So I'm outside of the table. I'm going to go ahead and click insert, and under scatter, I'm just going to click scatter. And it's going to draw out an empty chart box. And what I want to do now is go ahead and insert the data in there. So I'm going to go under, it's under the design tab in the chart tools contextual menu. I'm going to go ahead and select data. And when the select data source table comes up, I'm going to add data. So I'm going to add the XY data manually here. So the series name, I don't really need to worry about that. It'll just keep series 1. The X value, I want to select the X values here. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this cell, press Control Shift the down arrow to select everything, and that's my range of X values. For my Y values, I want to delete this equal these curly brackets in the number 1 and go ahead and do the same thing I did for the X values. Select that in cell C2, Control Shift down arrow to select that range of cells and click OK. All right, so now I'll go ahead and close this now. Click OK and close it. Now I've got my XY scatter. I'm going to delete these grid lines, or I'm going to delete these lines here. They're kind of just extra and they really kind of don't make it look that great. I want just the data points and the labels to show up. So generally when we put labels on, we can just select go ahead and select any of the data points and then right-click and go add data labels. But what you'll notice here is now it's just added the label for the, I believe this is the Y value. Let's see, let's select this. This is 1467, yeah. So it just added the Y value, and that's not what we want. Unfortunately, in Excel, there is no feature or inherent way to add data labels just by right-clicking or doing anything. You'd have to add a macro. And a macro is basically a small program that's written in Visual Basic to add that in there. Now, I'm not a expert in macros, and what I did was I picked this up off the Microsoft Knowledge Base, and so this is how we're going to do it. I'm going to go ahead and just Control-Z to undo, so we'll get rid of that. And the macro, It's off of the Microsoft website, and I have a copy of it here. I'll go ahead and provide a link to it in the description of this video. And all I need to do is just select that macro, Control C to copy it, and go back into my sheet here. Make sure that I go have the developer tab set up. If you don't have this developer tab in there, you can just add it on there. I have it here, but if you don't have it, you can just right click on any of the tabs and go ahead and say and click on customize ribbon. And in your main tabs, if you have this unchecked, you just go ahead and check it and click OK. I already have it checked, so I'm going to go and click OK. And once you have that developer tab here, what you want to do is you want to go into the Visual Basic command here, click on that, or just press Alt F11. It's going to bring up the Visual Basic application window. And you can see I already have it here. And this is the macro that I copied over. I copied over actually previously to this particular step here. But after I did that, I can just go ahead and close it. I can save it and close it, or I can just close it and it'll ask you to save it. And what I want to do now is I want to go ahead and go to Macros, and then click on this Attach to Labels and click Run. Once it does that, the macro automatically adds the labels in here. So you can see I can do a little cross-checking. Item 12 here is 4136. So it's about 4136. That's kind of correct there. So this is just a quick way that you can add these particular labels on there, because there's no way natively you can do it in Excel. You'd have to use a macro. And just a caveat on macros, on this particular macro, I believe you have to have this formatted like this. You have your labels on the first column, your X values on the second, and your Y values on the third. So just the caveat here is when you want to save this file, and you want to save it with the macro intact, that little program, you have to save it as an XLSM file. That's an Excel macro-enabled workbook. But if you didn't really care about, you're finished with the graph, you didn't really care about redoing it again and trying to run that macro, you can just save it as an XLSX file. So there's our little quick way of creating labels for an XY scatter diagram. Hope this helps. Thanks for watching.